Yes, maybe for the topic. What's our motion? The topic is. The topic is science is threat to humanity.
Science is causing a lot of devastation to the mankind. For example, if we take World War II as an example, the invention of nuclear bomb has caused a lot of devastation. The people of Japan has been facing a lot of problems in doing.
As you said, that nuclear bomb, they use it for defense. Because the project of nuclear bomb, say, we are now. Our country is protecting because of that nuclear bomb. If another country or some other country is going to attack to our country, then what?
The answer causes the environmental pollution, such as land pollution, sound pollution, and other pollutions also. What do you say?
If you want to live in a comfort zone, means you have to face all the difficulties.
I can't understand what is it? What is it?
Pollution is there, then we have
what? There is no mission which works on us, not with the
efficiency.
You are not related to the point, what are we saying?
You didn't understand the point, what have you now said?
We have inventing technology for our sake only. If the technology has caused a lot of devastation, then how it could be useful to us? For example, if science and technology has causing a lot of disadvantages, for example, greenhouse effect, ozone layer depletion, global warming, all these are affecting to us. If science and technology are affecting to us, then how? What is the need for inventing science and technology?
And also, birds, animals, and other living beings have been extincted due to the advancement of science and technology.
Compared to LHS, if one wants to go to any Kasi like long distance place, sometimes he will reach to the destination and sometimes he will die in the middle of the journey. And due to the advancement of transport technology,
you don't have that thing to come back to home. Because of the home, no way less. Because of this government process, we are allowing a comfort zone to reach to our places.
Science makes the people lazier. We can't do our own things like washing clothes and etc. Which are very easy.
For everything like that, there is time saving.
Attention to that, science has causing a lot. We are inventing medicines for our diseases. In turn, for example, science has also emitting a powerful virus which is affecting to our human health. For example, H1N1 virus, which causes a lot of devastation to the mankind. If we are inventing medicines to cure some diseases, but in turn, newborn diseases are emerging to the mankind.
Certainly you are right, but here, if the medicines are not invented, some people are also dying. If the medicines are
natural compost to in agriculture fields and refrigerators and etc. Why can't we use pots to cool, for the cool water, etc.?
That's what I was saying. But how we can use pots instead of refrigerators?
Arun, Arun, go that side. Send this girl. Okay, yeah, that is the right. Okay.
So, my point is, yes, we have many medicines and we have cured many diseases. But let us consider a person who is about 8 years old. I mean, I want to say a person who is in 1960s and a person who is in 2016. If you consider the inner potential or inner stamina of the persons, they are resistant to many diseases. Even they are not affected by zombies, smallpox at that time. But a fever can cause very huge damage in these people. So science and technology is reducing the resistive power of diseases in humans. What do you say, Mr.?
These medicines are to increase the resistive power of the man. So, no medicine will increase the resistive power. Even these medicines will get will increase the resistive power to face new problems and new viruses which is attacking us. So, there is no scope to say that the resistive power is getting lesser to these resistance. And also, as my fellow member said, in wilderness, to some tips, we usually go through walks, which I take, we pen up tips by walks. So we want to reach our destination at a specific time and at what time we want to reach it. Because nowadays aeroplanes are extra as lessened our time and we can capable of reaching our goals more quick. And also in advanced technologies, so many information we are getting through formulation etc. and to scientific instruments. Because we can say, so we can know how we are going to use the resources more effectively and what are the resources we are going to have in our future days to improve the quality of life.
We are traveling on aeroplanes, we are going to some other places and we are at the same time using carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, CFC, other gases and we are depleting the ozone layer. Is it necessary to travel to other places in order to cost the lives of humans? We are not supposed to kill other people for our own benefit. It is my wish to travel on an aeroplane or not, but I have no right to cause any damage or cause any ecological distress.
Now, there are so many engines, so many methods taken by the scientists and so many people to eradicate these problems to reduce the global problems. So, we can use it also effectively and we can't walk to some distances every time. So, we have to use this.
Is it necessary to write a 1 or 2 our hand after putting it into fire? No, it is not necessary. It is even better if we don't put our hand into fire. At the same time, it is unnecessarily and disagreeing with your argument. It is not necessary to find the preventive measures to decrease pollution. Initially, we are supposed to not cause the pollution.
If there is no scientific progress in our society, can you imagine the world today? In all this, is greedy. Always he want to kill other people and he want to conquer all the things he want. If there is no scientific progress also, the same output will come. There is no, but the scientific has given us a scope to how to utilize this properly and how to increase our life, quality of living and
yes, this science provided much more use for me because in older days a person will kill another person. But now using the hot hormones and passing skill can cut it easily, right?
Yes. If you take the measures, after that also use the measures and if they will not, he also use the measures. But after that use the measures to safeguard the country from other invasions and to get the resources, available resources. But Bin Laden has killed so many people, thousands of deaths with them. So it is not about the science and not about the thing. It is about the human brain who is utilizing it. And also in the US, they are using the measures and to safeguard the country from other invasions. They are using it as an umbrella. So you can't say that from this the scientific toxin, so many deaths are analyzed.
My friend, the first point is Abdul Kalam haven't used any missile. He just invented the missile. The second thing is, Bin Laden is a rebellion. He boldly destroys. And my point is, we are said, right? Scientists won't expect the aftermath. So they have created many things. But let me consider the devastation happened in World War II. After Hiroshima and Nagasaki, after these many generations, the people are facing genetic deformations. Are we supposed to see these people like that? Is it not a fault of science? Just wait a minute, let me finish. I have a beautiful quotation. If great power comes, great as great a responsibility. If at all there is no power, there is no responsibility. But if you have power, you have to be responsible. It is our responsibility, but the responsibility is being ruled by the science because power oppresses us.
As you said,
the
Abdul Kalam invented the middle by the Vietnam. cost we invented, we invented to use the missiles. Not only him, so many are using the missiles. So you can't say the point is that using missiles and because of the missiles are only this pollution is created.